My big WTF this WTF Wednesday, is not about corrupt governments. It's not about profiteering food companies or pharmaceutical companies or ignorant medical experts. It's about us. WTF are we thinking? Welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist. I am a sportsman. I follow the science around nutrition, and I try to do the right things to keep myself as healthy and fit as possible, and to give the best advice to my clients and to my followers and to my friends and my family. And I want to talk about sugar. Now, this is, I know everybody talks about sugar. We're tired of it. We've heard it before. But this is a real big what the WTF moment for me, because from talking about sugar forever, who hasn't heard this? Who hasn't heard that sugar is bad for you? Who actually doesn't already understand that sugar is bad for you? Who doesn't know already that lots of sugar is fattening? I think we've passed that point of that actually being a debate. Apart from these lunatics who recommend a sugar diet, I have no idea where that came from. Or maybe I do, but okay, we'll park that. There is still a sugar industry out there, so let's not forget that. And there's still money to be made from sugar. But okay, we know it's not good for us. We think, oh, too much sugar is fattening, so we cut down on our desserts, and we are kind of aware of the fact that we maybe shouldn't drink so many sodas and eat so many cupcakes. And sometimes it's difficult, but nobody's going to argue with you and say that it's good for you. Okay, fine. But that's the sweet sugar, the obvious sugar. The moment sugar comes in a form that doesn't taste sweet, we seem to think it doesn't count. But sugar is sugar. But we think the non-sweet sugar, so that means the sugar that does not contain a fructose element, so it's mostly glucose or starch. Hell, potatoes, pasta, bread, breakfast cereals, all those things, those are fine. And the things we hear are, those are natural sugars. Natural sugars are good for you. All sugar is natural. Sugar comes from plants. Plants make sugar. That's where it comes from. Sugar cane, table sugar. It's made from sugar cane. That's a plant. Or from beets. Sugar beet. That's a plant. Okay, sugar is natural and very bad for you. Honey is sugar. Honey is actually sucrose. Honey is table sugar. That's what it is. Oh, it's made by the bees. Yeah, well, so what? The rest of your table sugar is made by some plant as well. So there's no such thing as unnatural sugar. Sugar is not good for you. But unfortunately, not all sugar tastes sweet. And we associate sugar or sugary foods with that sweet taste. And we get fooled. And then we're told, oh, but carbohydrates, which, please, are sugar, complex carbohydrates, oh, so long chains of sugar are somehow good for us. Okay, so we can eat all these complex carbohydrates. It's complete and utter nonsense. And it's not just fattening. It causes disease over a period of time. Along with the obesity comes fatty liver disease, type 2 diabetes, heart disease, even Alzheimer's has been linked to sugar now, and in research circles is known as type 3 diabetes. So this isn't just about getting fat, this is about getting sick. But then why do we do it? Well, that is where this WTF thing comes along, because for starters, it is promoted relentlessly by the food companies, and you can understand why they would do that, because they make a lot of money from sugar or carbohydrates and carbohydrate-related products. And plant-based products, of course, plants make sugar, so this is all wrapped up in the same industry, and getting us to eat lots of breakfast cereals, lots of grains. Start early in the day, because that triggers you and makes you hungry for the rest of the day, then you'll be sure to eat lots more, and bread and pasta and all these refined products made of carbohydrates. And they not only advertise their goods themselves, they fund and sponsor politicians who they then have in their pockets. They fund the industry bodies, the non-governmental organizations that are supposed to promote health. They fund the journals that publish the science, and because they fund the journals, they get to put representatives on the editorial board, so then they have control over what gets published. So they control the narrative and they control the information flow, and they make sure that they keep us informed by basically lying to us and confusing us and telling us that, oh, you know, it's not so simple as that. Maybe sugar in some way is actually quite good for you and you need lots of carbohydrates. So I understand why they would do that. I don't respect them for it. I think it's a disgrace. But I understand why they would do it. They're trying to sell a product, and that's their job. Their job is their share price. They have no duty to you or to me or to our health as food companies. They're just companies. But then what about us? Why do we keep eating it? Well, for starters, we've been lied to. So we fall victim to this massive misinformation campaign. And we very often won't even consider or entertain the thought that maybe it's wrong and we've been lied to and we shouldn't be on this high grain, high carbohydrate, plant-based, high fiber diet that we've been told since the 1970s to be on. And let's be clear, since the 1970s, obesity, heart disease and diabetes have gone completely off the clock in every country that has instituted these guidelines. So clearly something's not right. So why do we do it? Why do we follow it when we've kind of heard, and we should by now be questioning and going, maybe this isn't quite right? And I think for a lot of us, to be frankly honest, is that it suits us. It suits us to accept that maybe it's not so clear. Maybe we do still need to be eating this stuff. Maybe it's not as bad as people say, because we are addicted. We are addicted to sugar in its various forms. We are absolutely addicted to sugar, and we don't really want to have to give it up and cut out all the carbohydrates and stop eating pizzas and stop eating all this other processed carbohydrate, grain-based non-food. We don't really want to do that. And so long as there's somebody out there telling us, no, it's actually fine, then we can justify to ourselves why we don't take that step, take responsibility for our own lives and see if we can't fix our health. Even if we have been sick for a long time, we're on medication, we have chronic weight issues, we have sugar intolerance, we have inflammation, we have all sorts of things. No, we don't really want to fix that. So that's my WTF. It's like WTF, are we thinking? What are we doing? What are we doing to ourselves? We're killing ourselves. We're poisoning ourselves with mucky non-food and then trying to manage the symptoms of our bad health with medication, which then also costs a whole lot of money and makes another whole industry really, really wealthy. And it's just really weird. So if you are one of those people who is looking after your own health, doing your best, you've cut the carbohydrates out of your diet, you're on a ketogenic diet, you've lost weight, you're much healthier, you've gone off your meds, maybe you're on a carnivore diet, which is a really sort of on the far end of ketogenic diets. I'm on a carnivore diet and I'm very healthy and very happy, but you don't have to be. Just cut the sugar out already. You know, that's a really good start. And you're doing that, and the people around you who you love and care about are not listening. They're arguing with you, and you can see how sick they are. You can see how overweight they are. You watch them popping pills every day, and they don't want to know, because they will quote somebody else or some other source or their doctor telling them that they have to eat this stuff and they need fiber for their gut and all these other completely debunked theories that we now know are nonsense. Saturated fat is good for you. It doesn't cause heart disease. If you are surrounded by people who are just not willing to even try. Imagine someone's been sick for 20 years and you give them this alternative idea that, hey, you know what? Why don't you try it for 3 months? If it doesn't work for you, you don't like it, tell me I was wrong and go back to eating the way you are. But if you've been sick for 20 years and you've been overweight for 20 years or 30 or 40 years and you've been on medication for decades and nothing seems to work, Why would you not try 2 or 3 months on a completely different diet just to see if this is actually true? And you might be, well, not might, you would be amazed at the difference it makes. Those people around you who you are not able to convince to even give it a try are just not ready. They are addicted. It's like trying to get a drug addict off their drugs. Even if they know in their heart of hearts that what they're doing is wrong, they are not prepared to do it yet because the consequences have not yet been severe enough. I only changed my diet when I had serious heart problems. I was properly overweight. I was facing heart surgery and a hip replacement, both of which I managed to avoid, and now I'm running again. My heart beats perfectly normally, and I've lost 45 pounds. And I'm healthy. And I don't eat most of the crap that the government guidelines tell me I should be eating. So it does work, but you have to be ready to do it. 10 years ago, I wasn't ready to do it. I wasn't going to listen. I wasn't sick enough. So you can only help the people around you when they are ready and they want to be helped. So don't despair. It's not your fault that you're not saving them, because they need to first be able to come and want to save themselves. Then you can help them. You can give them advice and you can point them in the right direction. So that's my what the F moment is. What the F are we doing to our own health when we know how bad sugar is? The science is there. The science is out there. We're not prepared to look at it, because it's very convenient for us to accept the lies from the industry, from the corrupt politicians and the governments and the institutions that have a vested interest in keeping us eating the way we eat, whether it's selling us the food or selling us the drugs to manage the results of eating that bad food. It suits us to believe them, because we are addicted. So this is going to be a massively difficult task to get the whole of society to change and start eating the correct way. But you know what? Every single person who changes the way they eat and starts eating correctly and starts improving their health is another little success story on this journey of trying to get society to where it should be. So you are absolutely part of that once you fix your diet and you make yourself healthy and you set yourself up as an example to everybody around you about how healthy you can be and how well you can do on the correct diet compared to how badly you were doing on the recommended diet for all those years. Please like this video, please subscribe to our channel, and please continue to spread the message and to be an example to those around you.